everyone, I know it really stinks being stuck at home and not being able to go to school. So I thought we'd do this. I'm going to be putting out a video a day here on our YouTube channel. And you can watch, interact along with. We're going to be putting up my email address here near the end so you can send me an email with some questions answered from the video. And what I thought we'd start with today is just kind of a fun one that we're going to go over hand washing again since it's been all over the news. So, you need several things to hand wash. First thing, you need soap. Soap does help. Second thing, you need water. And third thing, oh, we'll figure it out. So, first thing I'm going to do, I got some water. Let's wash our hands. So, got my hands nice and wet. Now, we're going to go ahead and put some soap on. That ought to do it. Now, when you're washing your hands, do make sure that you get the backs of your thumbs as well, because germs can hide there, and we know how much we hate germs. And as we're washing along, you know, it helps to pass time, because you should wash for 20 seconds. So it helps to think of a song. Let's see, what would be a good song? Oh, I know the first part of one of my favorites. Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. Kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling as a swirling storm inside. That's about 20 seconds. So now that I've got a good lather up, I need to,
Mr. Michelson, what are you doing? Oh my goodness, there's soap all over my floor!
Sink! That's what I forgot. Sink! I'll be back. So, washing without a sink is not really a good idea. We learned our lesson on that one. So, make sure when you wash your hands, yes, water good, soap good, sink really good. All right, we're going to be reading a story now, and I know how you all love Jeannie B. Jones, so we're going to do Jeannie B. Jones and the Yucky Blucky Fruitcake. So, chapter one is The Bestest Game Winner. My name is Jeannie B. Jones. The B stands for Beatrice, except I don't like Beatrice. I just like B, and that's all. I am in the grade of kindergarten. It's the afternoon kind. Afternoon kindergarten is better than morning kindergarten. That's because you get to sleep late and watch cartoons. Only guess what? Today, my baby brother named Ollie waked me up way too early. He was screaming for his bottle, but screaming is not like polite, and so he needed some discipline, I think. I sat up in my bed. Hey, shut your mouth, I hollered. Mother opened my door speedy quick. Her eyes were like angry at me. Jeannie B. Jones, what do you think you're doing? She growled. I hid it under my sheet. Think I'm doing discipline? I said, kind of quiet. Please, Junie B, not today, said Mother. Daddy and I need you to be on your best behavior. We have to go to work early, and Grandpa Miller's coming to babysit. Just then, I heard the front door open. Grandpa! It's my Grandpa Frank Miller! I shouted. I jumped out of the bed and ran to meet him. Only too bad for Grandpa, because he didn't see me coming around the corner, and I accidentally butted him in the stomach with my head. Grandpa Miller yelled the word, oof. Then he bended way over in half. And me and Mother and Daddy had to help him walk to the couch. Daddy did a frown at me. How many times have we told you not to run in the house? He said. I counted on my fingers. Like a million, trillion, scadillion, I think. Only I'm just kind of guessing. After that, Mother made me sit on her lap. And she told Grandpa Frank Miller the babysitter instructions on me. Babysitter instructions is all the stuff I'm not allowed to do, like climbing on top of the refrigerator, and no putting lipstick on the dog named Tickle, and no making baby Ollie lick a potato, except for he didn't actually mind licking a potato. After the babysitter instructions, Mother and Daddy kissed me goodbye. And then they went to work. I jumped way high in the air. Oh boy, now they're gone. So me and you can have some fun. Right, Grandpa? Right. I zoomed to the kitchen and climbed up on top of the refrigerator. Hey, Grandpa, come look where I am. Grandpa Frank Miller came up to the kitchen. Look how high I am up here. Now I can be the king, and this can be my throne. And you're my servant named Pinky, and you have to fetch me stuff. And also, I get to hit you on the head with my sword. Grandpa Frank Miller lifted me off the refrigerator and put me back on the floor. Yeah, only I didn't give you permission to do that, Pinky, I said. Sorry, little girl, but you heard the rules, said Grandpa. And anyhow, I have to finish feeding Ollie his breakfast bottle. He went back to the living room. Hey, Grandpa, you gave me a very great idea because I think I'll eat my breakfast too, only I can fix mine myself. And I hurried up and got the ingredients. The ingredients are the stuff you like all mixed together, like a bowl and a spoon and cereal and milk. Except the milk carton was way too heavy for me, so I got orange juice instead. I put my bowl of cereal on the floor and I poured my orange juicy to the tippy top and I took a big giant bite. Yum! This is the most delicious breakfast I ever ate, except for it doesn't actually taste good. Just then, Grandpa Miller came in the kitchen. He said, no eating on the floor. Yeah, but I don't like to sit in my big kitchen chair, I said, because I'm not tall enough to reach the table, and so Mother makes me sit on a telephone book, only that thing hurts my behindy. My grandpa looked in my bowl. What in the world are you eating? He asked. I am eating cereal and orange juice, I told him. It's very delicious, except it's going to make me puke. Then Grandpa Frank Miller opened the refrigerator so he could find me a better kind of breakfast. How about some fruit, he said. Yay for fruit, because fruit's like the bestest thing I love. I folded my hands very politely. I would like some bananas and some peaches and some strawberries, please. And so Grandpa Frank Miller sliced all those fruits into a bowl, and he let me eat them in the living room in front of the TV. And I'm not even allowed to do that either, only we're not telling Mother. And here's another fun thing. After breakfast, baby Ollie took his nap, and me and my Grandpa Frank Miller played Old Maid, and I winned him like 5 times in a row. That's because I kept putting the Old Maid card way higher than the rest of my cards, and he kept picking it. Grandpa Frank Miller is a sucker, I think. Me and him played lots more games, too. Their names were Who Could Skip the Fastest, and Who Could Hop on One Foot the Longest, and also a game of Tic-Tac-Toed. And guess what? I win them all those games, too. I'm the bestest game winner in the whole world. Then I run to my room to get ready for kindergarten. First, I put on my favorite pants with the polka dotties on them. Then I found my favorite sweater with the cow on the front. It was in the dirty clothes hamper, only it didn't even stink, well, that much. After that, I combed my hair with my fingers and I brushed my teeth, except for not the wiggly one because I didn't want it to pop out. Grandpa made me a sandwich for lunch. Its name was Jack Cheese. I ate it all up, gave him a big kiss, and I skipped to my school bus very happy because I'm the bestest game winner. I'm the bestest game winner. Because winning is like the funnest thing that I love. And tomorrow, we'll read chapter 2, Hopping and Racing and Tic-Tac-Toed.
Hey, Mr. Michelson, are we going to wear special shirts tomorrow?
Oh, that's right. At my house, we're doing a different theme day for each day that we're not in school. It's just something kind of fun. So I'm going to be wearing a Marvel shirt tomorrow. If you have a Marvel superhero shirt that you want to wear, go ahead and wear that too, because it'd be kind of fun. All right, we'll see y'all in a little bit. Hey, I hope you liked the story as much as I did. We're going to wrap it up today with a quick little number talk. So we're going to work today with the number 20. And we're going to talk about different ways that we can represent 20. One of the things that I can think of right away when I talk about representing 20 is this, the name 20. So, Oh, you know what? Really easy math problem. Y'all like to shout out at me all the time. I know what 10 plus 10 is. Yes, I know you know what 10 plus 10 is. So 10 plus 10 does equal 20. So what else can you come up with to represent 20? I've given you a couple of ideas right here. 10 plus 10 and it's the word 20. But what can you come up with? If you've got an idea, go ahead and email me here at mikelej@nv.ccsd.net. The people who can come up with an idea will get a shout out on our next video, and I'll give you a sticker when we get back to class. All right. It's been great seeing you guys again, and I'll see you again tomorrow. Remember, tomorrow, Marvel theme day if you have a Marvel shirt. And take care.